Yo, good morning, good people. Hope you can hear me. This is episode one of Spotlight Herbs, and this one right here needs no introduction. This is the sea moss here, you know. Real deal. Should look like this. But it's tumbleweed. See how it looks before it's hydrated, you know. As I get back into my health journey, to get back to where I was health-wise, this was a go-to for me. This is a superfood, you know, all-natural, powerful antioxidant. It's like an all-in-one. You can get rid of your multivitamins and everything of that nature. As you know, this contains 92 of 102 minerals that you need for health. This is vital for optimal health. Just a quick overview of some of the things that it's good for before I get into my personal journey with it. But this is good for increasing your energy levels. So it's good for metabolism and immune support. Boost testosterone and bone density and strength in men. It's also a weight loss and muscle building aid, and will aid in the production of red blood cells. In women in particular, it's good for menstrual cycles and fertility, thyroid issues in both sexes. What else can it be? Good for skin care and acne, so it can be used as a facial mask to aid in hair growth and healthy hair. It has a lot of anti-aging properties. But one thing that's important, you know, in men in particular, this is great for your prostate health, sexual health, you know, and one thing we underestimate, this is great for your gut health and digestion. A lot of times people, the top quality sea moss you can get is probably your purple sea moss, but you have green sea moss as well, and you have different varieties of sea moss. But there's actually a difference between, you see some people get Irish moss confused with sea moss. This is sea moss, and this is the gold variety. These are more commonly found. They're fish from the sea and dried in the sun. The difference between Irish moss and sea moss, and Irish mosses are actually more superior as well. The Irish moss tends to grow in, you know, cooler water, cooler climates in Europe and North America, things like that. And this sea moss, you know, is grown in warmer climates, you know, South Africa, the Caribbean, and Asia, everywhere like that. That's where you get your sea moss. But this is sea moss gold. But we'll get into, as I take this journey, we'll try several different things. I've been using Jamaican sorrel, hibiscus lately, but we'll get into that in the next episode. But yeah, this is vital. This is definitely something that you need to tap into on your health journey. So as you can see here, you know, I used to sell this. I had a business called Better Life Naturals, and this was my first product, the sea moss. And as you can see, you know, it's rich in magnesium, iodine, iron, you know. Everything you need is in here, man. Don't sleep. Definitely get us a shot. Like I said, you can replace your multivitamins. And, you know, this comes right out of the water. Right out of the water. Get rid of that medicine and everything. These are the directions for your gel, you know. And so I guess this is a good time for me to segue into my own personal experience. Okay, we'll give these people a plug. This is not who I got mines from, but this is a good company. And the type of gold sea moss is Euchema spinosa. And there are several types of sea moss. You got Euchema contini, you got Chandra's crispus. There's several varieties of sea moss, but this is one of the top ones here. And you always want it to be wild harvested, because a lot of times you find cool grown varieties of sea moss, and it won't really have this appearance. It'll have a whiter appearance and be more heavily caked with salt, and it'll be thicker. And in order to speed up production, a lot of times they grow them in the pool. And by any means, do not neglect or not start your journey because of that. But those mosses are less beneficial for you than this, which grows on the bottom of the ocean floor. My experience with this, when I was on my health journey, I started off with a black seed oil, which we'll cover. And I learned about this through Dr. Sabi and King Earn. That's how I learned about this. And on YouTube. So, you know, I got it. I would make my gels with it. You know, I would soak it. I would first rinse it thoroughly because, you know, you have you have sand and things like that. Debris that's attached to it that comes from the sea. So what I would do is I would rinse it thoroughly. I would grab a lemon or two, squeeze the juice into a bowl, and add this naturally alkaline water. You can get this gallon for $1.25 right here. I buy these by the case. It's already alkaline water. So I would soak this for anywhere from 8 to 24 hours to rehydrate. It'll grow in size. And what I would do after that is I would rinse it again, get a blender, equal parts of water for however much you use, and I would blend it. You can't use any blender. You need something powerful, NutriBullet, Ninja, like a powerful blender to break this stuff down. And it comes, you know, to like a thick pudding-like consistency once you blend it. And you put it, you need to put this in a jar. It needs to be stored in an airtight jar in the refrigerator. It will solidify and be more of a like a gel-like consistency. And that's how you want it. Now, you can heat this up and basically milk it on a stove in water. But the heat will kill off some of the nutritional properties of this plant. This is all natural. So it will still be beneficial for you, but the best way to do it is to not put that heat to it and try it. It definitely helps in weight loss. One of the things it did for me, and it does for everybody, this, once you start to take the gel, I would mix it with tea and honey and things of that nature. It has a sea-like taste. You can tell it comes from the water. What it would do for me and what it does for everyone else, it's like draining that gel. A lot of times you're carrying around a lot of weight, and you know, because of bile, poop in your intestines. So that it's like draining. This will go through your body, go through your intestines, and grab any of that that's in the intestines that's cancerous. It's just sitting there against the walls, and it'll drag that all the way out, and it'll come out easy. You'll use the bathroom to boop. There'll be no struggle. It'll slip right out of there. You know, this is good to clean you out. It will clean you out. It will detoxify you. It will get all of that stuff out of your body ASAP. And that's what I like the most about it. So you'll realize that you've been carrying around a lot of extra weight because of what's attached to the inside of your intestines that this will bring out. So it will aid in that. When you're using this, you also want to step up your water intake for the optimal best results. Increase your water intake when dealing with this particular herb. You know, it's very popular within the last 3 to 4 years. It has increased in popularity. Like I said, this is good for testosterone production, energy, strength. Any of you fellas, you're in the gym, women, you're in the gym, this is your go-to right here. It's all in one, does a little bit of everything. So, like I said, back to the shameless plug. I used to sell it. I still can plug you into it. But this is a pound from a company called Atlantic Gold. And here you go, some of the things right here, rich in essential minerals for optimal health, sustained energy, alkaline, healthy skin and hair. You know, huge nutritional boost, huge benefits here. Not sleep on this. As you can see, this is from St. Lucia, Caribbean warm water algae. You know, So, you know, give this a try, you know. Start your health journey with this. This should be a go-to if you're going to get into this. A lot of people, problem that I had when I was selling it is that it sells in cycles because people have to use it. You know, so people will use it and then, you know, it'll take a while before they call you back to get some more. Like, but this should be a go-to. Any herbs that I will spotlight here on Spotlight Herbs needs to be go-to things that, you know, you take with you for the rest of your life. Keep this in play. So I'm getting ready to start a new cycle with this soon. I'll probably make a video showing you how I make it as well. But, you know, we're not going to be too long-winded about it. The information is there. Google sea moss benefits, sea moss Dr. Sabi, whatever you want to Google. Do your research on this, man. And please, if you've never given it a shot, give it a shot and work it into a routine. Make it a part of your life and your existence. I believe in cycling and shocking your body. So I wouldn't take anything every day because I've also believed too much of anything hurt you. This has never hurt me. I've never heard of it hurting anyone, but that's just me. But I cycle things. So this, whatever batch I make of this, I'm going to take that until it runs out. It usually takes me, I can say I would use, this is a 1 pound bag. I would say I'm probably going to soak down and process about a half pound of this, and it'll take me 2 weeks. You can put it into, like I said, it says it right here, soup, stews, desserts, everything. I just take it straight up with tea, and I'll have a few cups of that a day. And when that's done, I will go off sea moss, because the effects linger in your body for up to a month anyway. But once your body gets used to things, they don't perform as well once your body gets used to having them. So you want to shock your body. So I'll cycle on for sea moss. I'll use sea moss for about 2 weeks, and then I'll cycle off of it for a couple of weeks. Then I'll cycle back on it for 2 more weeks and shock my body. So it's like my body's experiencing it for the first time. And you have to trick your body in order to get the optimal results from these things, from anything. But there you have it. That's episode 1, Spotlight Herbs. We have Gold Sea Moss. Signing off.